Good evening, everybody. I know you're not all here for me, so it's great to have you all here tonight. And for this special evening service, the kids are very excited to offer their performance of Joseph from the Pit to the Palace. Just a reminder, a quick reminder to turn off any cell phones. And also, the kids are going to be coming through the aisles at the very beginning, so make sure that you have all your belongings underneath the pew in front of you. I think that's all we've got for announcements. The kids have worked very hard on this musical, and they've also worked very hard to do this for the Lord. Their desire is to worship the Lord. And so they want you to join in with them in worshiping as you hear them sing and as they present this musical. Right now, we actually have the opportunity to worship through giving. So let's just go ahead and pray together. For those of you who are visitors, please don't feel obligated to give. This is for regular attenders. But please join me in prayer. Father, we thank you so much for the opportunity to hear kids sing praises to you. And we pray that you would calm their hearts, that you would help them to focus on you, and that you would be glorified through this musical tonight. And Lord, we thank you for this opportunity to praise you through giving the hard-earned money that we have worked to earn. But Lord, all of our money is yours, and we're just grateful that we can offer back some of it to you in worship. In your name, amen. Forgot one quick announcement. We actually need one more nursery worker. If you are already approved to work in the nursery, we would love to have some extra help in there. I guess there's a lot of kids here tonight. So you could just slip back there now. They would really appreciate the help. Thank you.
Welcome, everyone. Tonight's going to be exciting because we're celebrating the life of Joseph.
Even though Joseph lived almost 4,000 years ago, his life shows us how we can live today.
Joseph knew God and trusted him. And in Joseph's life, we see the godly character that the Lord wants to develop in all of us.
Tonight, we want you to be part of this Stomp and this celebration. So watch the screens for your cues, hold on to your seats, watch, listen, and learn as Joseph goes from the pit to the palace.
Party, Joseph.
Joseph, this is your life. You grew up in the land of Canaan with your father Jacob and your 11 brothers. You were the second youngest. Tonight we have some special guests to help us come celebrate. See if you recognize this voice.
You are such a cute little boy, and your father loved you so much. He had big plans for your life and made a special coat just for you.
Oh, why, that's Bilhah, our housekeeper. My old coat. I loved that coat, but it sure caused a lot of problems with my brothers.
You can say that again. And when you were 17 years old, your life got turned upside down. See if this brings back memories.
Become of his dreams.
Hey guys, look over there. What do you see?
I see a caravan heading our way. What do you see?
I see opportunity knocking. That's a group of Israelites going to Egypt to do some trading. Have I got a deal for them? We let Joseph die in that pit. What's in it for us?
Nothing!
Let's sell them to the Israelites to make a little money.
He'll be going, going, gone.
He's going, 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 he's going
Joseph, I can't imagine going through something like that. Weren't you scared? Didn't you feel hurt and alone?
Yeah, it was the pits. But God's always faithful, and he helped me. When you're going through tough times, you just have to remember that God's with you. And you really aren't alone, because God's right there with you. Just trust him, and he'll help you through your pitiful situation.
Joseph, when you got to Egypt, our next guest bought you from the Ishmaelite traders.
Oh, you're talking about Potiphar, Pharaoh's captain of the guard.
That's right.
Joseph! He was my most trusted servant in all my household. I could tell that God was with him because he blessed everything, because God blessed everything that I owned. I'm no dummy. I put him in charge of my household and fields. Because of him, God blessed all that I owned. Everything was fine until my wife, she tried to get him to sin, but he was a man of integrity and obeyed God's laws.
Joseph, you did the right thing.
Well, it wasn't really me. It was all from God. He gives us a way out when we're faced with sin. It's up to us to choose his way.
And that's what you did. You didn't think twice. You knew just what to do.
Yeah.
Even though you had done nothing wrong, Potiphar believed his wife's lies and sent you to prison. You were there a long time, but you had courage and endurance. And God kept blessing you, and soon you were in charge of everything that went on in the prison. That's where you met two very interesting people.
Oh, you're talking about Pharaoh's cupbearer and baker. When we were in prison together, they had strange dreams, and God gave me the meaning of the dreams.
And 2 years later, Pharaoh had strange dreams too. Remember this?
Not understand my two dreams, so I command. Who will tell me what these mean about these seven fat cows and seven lean? Inform me now. Who will explain about these 14 heads of grain with seven good and seven burned, the meaning which I should learn?
I know a man, I do, O king, and through his God interprets dreams. I would not, should not have forgotten about this man, and I feel rotten. His name is Joseph, this Hebrew. He'll be here soon to speak with you. His God will help him to explain all about the cows and grain.
Greetings, Pharaoh, and hear these things. God has told me about your dreams. Know these words from God are true, for he's revealed what he's about to do. The seven fat cows and seven lean, here's what they mean. 7 years of plenty and seven of lean. The abundant years will produce great crops, but when the famine comes, all that stops. Find a wise and discerning man. Put him in charge of Egypt land. When, for 7 years, store up grain, and you'll have food when famine reigns.
I would not, could not. Yes, it's true. Find one better than this Hebrew. You're a strong and godly man. You're now in charge of Pharaoh's land.
Yes, sir.
Joseph, when you were 30 years old, you got a big promotion. You went from the pit to the palace. How did you remain so humble?
People tried to give me credit for interpreting the dreams and storing the grain, but it wasn't for me. It was all from God. It's not about me. It's all about him.
It's all about you, Lord. It's not about me. It's you.
everything God said came true. There are 7 years of great crops, and then 7 years of famine started. Soon, people from all other countries came to Egypt to buy the grain you had stored. This brought some very interesting visitors.
Begged us not to harm him, but we wouldn't listen.
Didn't I tell you not to hurt the boy? Now we have to pay for what we've done. This is what we deserve. Payback time.
Here's the grain. I can't believe my brothers didn't recognize me. They've changed too. God has changed their hearts.
I've often wondered, what would I say if by chance I saw you one day? Would I be angry, seeking revenge, or would I turn around and just look away? What you meant for harm, God used for good.
Joseph, can I ask you a personal question? After all that your brothers did to you, how are you able to forgive them and show them compassion?
I spent a lot of time talking with God about that. God helped me to forgive them. God forgives me when I sin against him, and he expects me to forgive others when they sin against me.
That's hard to do.
But with God, all things are possible.
Well, the famine continued, and once again, your family in Canaan ran out of food, and your father Jacob had no choice but to let your brothers take Benjamin back to Egypt. That's when this man became a key player.
Hello, Mr. Joseph. I know you remember me. I was your go-to guy during Operation Give 'Em Grain.
I know that voice anywhere. It's my steward, Stu.
Good evening, Mr. Joseph. I'll never forget the day that your brothers returned to Egypt. As soon as you saw them, you turned to me and said, Stu, we're throwing a party. Prepare a feast. Mr. Joseph, when you saw your brothers and you saw your younger brother, and I believe he was a musician, I believe his name was Benjamin?
It's Benjamin, Stu.
Oh, sorry. Anyway, when you saw him, you got teary-eyed and had to leave the room. I could tell he was your favorite. When it was time for your brothers to return home, you had me set up a little surprise for them. Do you remember what that was, Mr. Joseph?
I certainly do, Stu. Operation Bring 'Em Back. We put the money they paid for back in their sacks, and in Benjamin's sack, we put my silver cup.
When they had gone just a short way from town, you had me go and get them. I had those boys open their bags, and I accused them of being thieves. Don't you know they were shocked?
Yes!
Don't you know they were confused?
Yes!
Don't you know they were scared?
Yes!
And don't you know I loaded them up on their donkeys and trotted them right back to Mr. Joseph?
Yes!
And here's what happened next.
Caught, and you, with my silver cup, you will be my slave. The rest of you can go home to your father.
Please, sir, please don't do this. Benjamin is our father's youngest son. It will kill him if the boy doesn't come home. Please let me be your slave instead. Let Benjamin go home with my other brothers. It will break my father's heart if he doesn't come home.
I can't take it any longer. I've got to tell them who I am. Come closer. Please, come closer. I'm Joseph, your brother who you sold to the Ishmaelite traders. Now don't be afraid, and don't be upset with yourselves because of what you've done. God put me in Egypt ahead of you so he could keep our family alive during the famine. God put me in Egypt, not you.
Joseph, is it really you?
We never thought we'd see you again. It's been more than 20 years.
You're alive and in charge of Egypt. I can't believe it.
All this to accomplish God's plan. He knows all, he's all powerful and he knows all things, including the future. He's an amazing and mighty God.
Thank you.
must be going out. Am I coming in?
Joseph, we have one more chapter of your life to celebrate. We know you could never forget this voice.
The happiest day of my life was when your brothers came home and told me that you were alive. Our family moved to Egypt to be near you, so God could provide for us during the last 5 years of the famine.
Why, that's my father, Jacob.
Son, I was amazed of all that had happened to you and that you were second in command of Egypt. Through all your trials, you trusted God because you knew him and understood his character. I'm so proud of the man you have become. God has truly done a great work in your life.
Thank you, Father. And thanks to all of you for this wonderful celebration tonight. But all the praise and glory should go to God. God is faithful. He was with me for every step of the journey, and he was in control of all that happened. God brought me to Egypt. God blessed me in the house of Potiphar and in prison as well. God sent Pharaoh's dreams and gave me the interpretation. God placed me in command of Egypt, all of this to accomplish his plans. But I'm no different than you. Just as God did for me, he will see you through every circumstance that comes your way. And more than that, he will bless you and teach you and mold your character. So know him and trust him. And if you're willing, God will give you the privilege of being involved in his plans. He is the all-powerful, all-knowing, ever-present God. Let's praise him now and forever.
coming out this evening and supporting the kids. Let's give him one more round of applause. Well, I think that the kids would also like to thank, I want to say the Inside Voices Choir wants to thank their fearless leader, Valerie Schumacher. And the Joyful Noise Choir would love to thank Deborah Graham. Thank you. And there were lots of other leaders who poured lots of time into this. Daniel Schumacher, Deborah and Brandon Graham, Madeline and Bobby Frere, Becca Donovan, Ellen, Lewis, and all of you parents, thank you so much for pouring so much time into your kids, helping them learn their parts. So thank you very much. So the kids have done such a wonderful job of illustrating for us the biblical Joseph, and I don't want us to miss the truths that we saw here today, because these are profound, really, when you think about it. You think about a young man who went through so much at the hands of his brothers, and he didn't become bitter, he didn't become vengeant, he didn't want vengeance, even though he went through terrible things. He was thrown in the pit. He was sold into slavery. He was thrown into prison. Yet through it all, he trusted God, and he trusted God's faithfulness. And God was faithful. God was working through that to preserve Joseph's family and keep alive the nation of Israel. So how was Joseph able to forgive like that? He was able to forgive because he kept his eyes on the Lord and saw that God was sovereign over everything that happened to him. And he kept his eyes on the Lord, the one who forgives sinners who deserve punishment and judgment. After Joseph's father, Jacob, died in Genesis, we see this record of an interesting interaction between Joseph and his brothers. Joseph's already forgiven them, and this is what happens. They send a message to him. They've already moved to Egypt, and they say, Joseph, please forgive the transgression of your brothers and their sin because they did evil to you. And now please forgive the transgression of the servants of the God of your father. Joseph wept when they spoke to him. His brothers also came and fell down before him and said, behold, we are your servants. But Joseph said to them, do not fear, for am I in the place of God? As for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, to bring about that many people should be kept alive as they are today. So do not fear, I will provide for you and your little ones. That's amazing. So even after he had forgiven them, Joseph's brothers, they still didn't trust that he wouldn't get vengeance on them, especially after Jacob died. Yet he still forgave them. And the interesting thing that he says is, am I in the place of God? I think that's the key. He knew the truth that God is the one who punishes sin. And he knew that he was a sinner just like them, and that God had forgiven him, so he needed to forgive them. So the question is, have you all been able to forgive hurts? All of us have been hurt in our lives. All of us are sinners. Romans 3:23 says, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So all of us have sinned, and the question is, have you been able to forgive others? If you haven't been able to forgive others, maybe you've never trusted in Christ, because the mark of a believer is someone who forgives. Jesus said, if you don't forgive your brother, then our Father in heaven won't forgive you. So this is what Joseph has demonstrated to us and what we got to see here tonight. And so the question is, if you've never trusted in Christ, if you've never been able to forgive for the hurts and the wrongs that have been done to you, if you're holding on to bitterness and anger, you need to turn to Christ today and repent of that bitterness. Recognize that you are a sinner and that you need forgiveness from God, the only one who's holy, the only one who's just. And the place that you can find that forgiveness is in Jesus Christ. Jesus went to the cross, and Jesus was perfect. He never sinned, and he paid the price on the cross for sinners, for all who trust in him. So I urge you today, if you don't know Christ, trust him today. Turn away from your sin and trust that his death on the cross paid for your sins. And if you do know Christ, remember that we're all sinners and we need to forgive others as God has forgiven us so much, so much. So let's take some time to pray now, and we'll also pray for the refreshments we're about to have and thank the Lord for this evening. Father, we thank you so much for these lessons that we've gotten to learn from the life of Joseph. We thank you for the kids and all their hard work in pouring their hearts out to honor you. And I pray that we would remember the truths that we've learned, that we would remember how you work in our lives. Even through the bad circumstances, you are working. And if we trust you, we know that you are working what's best for us because you are good. And Lord, I do pray if there's someone here tonight who is holding on to bitterness, who's never been able to forgive, Lord, that you would cause them to drop to their knees and just be humbled and see and recognize their own sin and their need for forgiveness from you, that they would trust in Jesus and him alone for salvation and turn to you for salvation. Lord, we thank you that you've given us this opportunity now to get some refreshments and enjoy fellowship. We pray that you'd be honored with the rest of this evening. In your name, amen.